What's up, everybody? So you've been playing around with your phone and you're looking for something new and you're thinking about installing some beta profiles. Let's check out the developer profile and talk about whether or not you should install it. So beta profiles. I know a lot of people that are into them and want to play around with the newest, latest, and greatest stuff. Most of them are tech people, but I totally understand. You have a phone, you've been messing with it for a while, and you want something new to kind of spark some interest back into your phone, and you're kicking around the idea of installing a profile. Now, there's two different types of profiles. There's a public profile and a developer profile. They're kind of self-explanatory. The public profile is for people who are not super technical, but kind of know what they're getting into, and they want to play around with their phone and are willing to take a little bit of risk. The developer profile typically come out a little bit before the public profile, and they're for developers. They're a little bit more risky. They might have some problems. You might get some bugs. They've been unstable in the past, and they're for people that are willing to take that risk. Should you do this? Well, that answer is really up to you. If you are comfortable with potentially having a phone that has a feature that doesn't work, for example, I remember not that long ago not being able to connect to my watch with a beta profile, and I had to wait till the next profile came out. And I had a problem with a profile on my Mac where I wasn't able to use a third screen for like 2 or 3 weeks because Monterey had a problem with one of the beta profiles. So it's really up to you. If you're willing to take that risk and you want to play with some new stuff, I'm going to show you how to install the profile. So let's dive into it. You're not going to need a computer for this part. But I do recommend that you back it up first or check on your iCloud backup to make sure that's good beforehand because you never know. You could get a update that has a bug in it that really messes with you and you want to go back to your stock software. And if you don't have a backup, that could be really difficult. Most of these you can't roll back to the previous version. You have to do a full restore. So make sure you have your backups done first. So the first thing you're going to want to do is using Safari, you're going to want to head over to betaprofiles.com. Now it's going to ask you to authenticate with a CAPTCHA, but once you get past that part, you should land on their homepage. And down bottom, you'll see a couple different options. This is an iPhone, so we're going to select iOS, but the process is pretty much the same for iPads and the tvOS. The watch is a little bit different, but we're not going to get into that right now. So we're going to click on iOS. And when it comes up, you're gonna have two options: install profile and select IPSW. We're not gonna mess with the IPSW for now. Go ahead and select install profile. It's gonna give you a warning about how you should have a backup for your phone, and definitely, like I said, back up your phone. But if you've got a backup and you're ready to continue, click install anyways. Now it's gonna ask you, are you sure you wanna do this? Go ahead and click allow. Then it's gonna tell you the profile has been installed and you have to continue in settings. So click on close. Go back to your home screen, open up settings, pull down so they get the search bar up top. Once you've got that search bar, type in VPN. Now you're gonna see VPN pop up, and then right underneath that, you should see VPN and device management. Go ahead and select that. And now you'll notice down bottom, you have a iOS 15 beta software profile. Go ahead and click on that. It's gonna show you the profile, show that it's verified by Apple, and ask you if you wanna install it. Go ahead and click install. Type in your code. Once you've typed in your code, it's going to give you the mumbo jumbo accepting all their terms and conditions. If you accept it, go ahead and click install. Click install again. And now your profile is installed. And when you reboot and select and search for an update, it'll show you the latest beta. In this case, it would be beta 4 for iOS 15, available for download. You can go ahead and install it. Now, one of the other things you might want to do if you change your mind is uninstall the profile. So you're gonna do the same thing. You're gonna be in settings, click on VPN, select VPN and device management, select the profile, click remove profile, type in your code again. And it's gonna ask you, are you sure you wanna remove it? Go ahead and click remove. And then you'd restart. And then you'd be back in the regular update cycle. You would not receive any more beta updates after that. So, I hope this has been helpful, and I hope you enjoy messing around with the beta software. I know it's a lot of fun. I enjoy it, especially with the beta 15, the beta for iOS 15. There were lots of cool little features to play around with, so I totally understand if you're into that kind of thing and you want to mess around. Thank you so much for stopping by the channel. I definitely would appreciate a thumbs up and a comment below. Let me know what kind of videos you'd like to see me do. And as always, I appreciate the subscription. Peace.